We have a national emergency, brothers and sisters. As many of you have probably been watching and hearing, that the President of the United States of America just declared a national emergency. And what we want to look at here is, what is a national emergency? What is this all about in light of Bible prophecies? Notice with me on the screen. This is from Facts 17, February 15, 2019. Trump declares national emergency to build border wall. Let's pause. Now, remember, we have covered this for the past couple months, the past 2-3 months. We dealt with this crisis that has been brewing down in the southern border. And we looked at this carefully, and we saw that the papacy was the one behind sending these migrants to the southern border of the United States, just like he did in Europe, to invade Europe. And we also looked at that. We saw it was the same thing that happened to pagan Rome, that destroyed pagan Rome, and that annihilated, or that divided Rome. That divided Rome into 10 nations. Now, we also looked at this to show you that how Bible prophecy is being fulfilled, that this was going to lead to a martial law. What do we mean by martial law? Well, let's go back to the article. Notice from Facts 17 again. It goes on to say, battling with one branch of government and opening a new confrontation with another, President Donald Trump announced Friday he was declaring a national emergency to fulfill his pledge to construct a wall along the U.S.-Mexico border. Notice with me, what does it mean for you and I? What does the Bible say about this nation, the United States of America? Notice, back to the screen, from Revelation chapter 13, verses 11 and 12. The Bible says, "And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a what? As a dragon, and he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed." So where are we? Based on Trump's declaration of a national emergency, this is part of the second beast here, speaking as a dragon. We'll come back to that. Notice the next article here. What Sister White says, speaking of the second beast. Great controversy, 442, paragraph 1. The lamb like horns and a dragon voice of the symbol point to a strong contradiction between the professions and the practice of the nation thus represented. The speaking of the nation is the action of its legislative and judicial authorities. By such action, it will give the lie to those liberal and peaceful principles which it has put forth as the foundation of its policy. The prediction that it will speak as a dragon and exercise all the power of the first beast plainly foretells a development of the spirit of intolerance and persecution that was manifested by the nations represented by the dragon and the leopard-like beast. And who was the leopard-like beast? That's none other than the papacy. So what we are seeing here, it was the theses versus antitheses. The papacy had been pushing for an open border, sending the migrants there. Now Trump is taking the next step, declaring a national emergency. What is that again? Next article, notice, from Miami Herald. Trump tests presidential power, declares emergency where? At border. Next article, it goes on to say, from the New York Times, Trump declares national emergency to build border wall. We are going to confront, notice he said, the national security crisis on our southern border. And we're going to do it one way or the other, he said. It's an, what's the word there? Invasion. He added, we have an invasion of drugs and criminals coming into our country. So he's taking the next step to stop what they call, quote unquote, illegal immigrants. Invasion of drugs and criminals coming in. Notice, next article here. It says from BBC News, Trump national emergency, a major land grab for the president. Now we're getting into a little bit more detail of what it means by the president to declare a national emergency. It says it's a major land grab by the president. Let's get some more context, some more understanding. Notice, next article says, this is from Quartz, February 15, 2019. What happens when a president declares a national emergency? Notice carefully. A declaration of a national emergency gives a president broad powers that include, notice carefully, taking control of communication networks, declaring curfews, and limiting citizens' movements. Now, taking control of communication networks, that would be social media, even your cell phone, your telephone. Do you see what this is about now? Notice, let's get some more understanding. Same article goes on to say, these might include, as a 2007 Congressional Research Service report lays out, the right to, notice carefully, seize property, organize and control the means of production, seize commodities, assign what? Military forces abroad, institute, what's the word? Martial law. Seize and control all transportation and communication, regulate the operation of private enterprise, restrict travel, and in a variety of ways, control the lives of United States citizens. The commander-in-chief can assert these rights without explanation. What does it mean, brothers and sisters? It sounds pretty good. To keep us safe, Trump wants to build that wall. And because of the disagreement between his administration and the Democratic-controlled Congress, now he is, quote-unquote, forced to declare a national emergency, which means a martial law. He can do all of what we just read from this article. He can shut down communications. He can impose a curfew, impose a martial law, and deploy the military within the United States of America's soil and streets, brothers and sisters. This is where we are. What does it mean? What does this mean? Well, he is speaking of the second beast, is speaking as a dragon. Notice what Sister White says here, where this is going to lead. Notice, from Vivian Herald, December 18th, 1888. A time is coming when the law of God is, in a special sense, to be made void in our land. The rulers of our nation will, by legislative enactments, enforce the what? The Sunday law. And thus God's people to be brought, or be brought, into great peril when our nation in its legislative councils shall enact laws to bind the consciences of men in regard to their religious privileges, enforcing Sunday observance, and bringing oppressive power to bear against these who keep the seventh day Sabbath, the law of God will, to all intents and purposes, be made void in our land. And notice carefully, and national apostasy will be followed by national ruin. This is where this speaking as a dragon is going to take this nation, not only to a national ruin, but also to trampling down the law of God, and to persecute those who would dare keep the Sabbath versus Sunday sacredness. that is giving breath or life to the image of the beast, to the papacy. Notice what it goes on to say here. It says, this peril now threatens the people of God. And what are we going to do? Notice the question there. Can we not assist in lifting the standard and in calling to the front those who have a regard for their religious rights and privileges? God calls upon us to do what? To awake. We know the end is near. We know that the prophecies are fast fulfilling, which show that we are living in the close of this world's history. So what are we supposed to do as we see these things happening? Keep in mind what Jesus says in Matthew chapter 24, verse 14. Now, this was after he mentioned the wars and rumors of wars and persecution. He says, this gospel, verse 14 of Matthew 24, of the kingdom shall be preached unto all the world as a witness, and then shall the end come. That's our commission. That's what we need to do at this time. And as Christ says in the book of John, now is the time for us to work while it is day. The night cometh. The night is coming. The Sunday law is coming. Religious freedom is being taken away from us little by little. Now, as the question was asked, back to the screen one more time. This peril now threatens the people of God. And what are we going to do? Next question. Can we not assist in lifting the what? The standard. And in calling to the front those who have a regard for their religious rights and privileges. It is no time for us to be quiet, brothers and sisters. Now we have an opportunity to help open the eyes of the blind. Those who have some understanding, but cannot see very well, cannot understand fully what's taking place. Now we have an opportunity to proclaim the final message for this time and to help open the eyes of the blind. And the dumb will start speaking again. Thank God, brothers and sisters, for giving us this great opportunity to work for Him in these last days. Let's pray. Loving Father, which art in heaven, what an exciting time that we are living in. And all of these signs, and as we see the development of Bible prophecies, these things tell us that You are coming again. And help us to have this zeal, like we love to sing the song, Jesus is coming again, but to do our part at the same time, because there are many souls who have not heard or who are still in the valley of decision, and they need someone to come and to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ to them. Lord, give your people, those who want to serve you with all their heart, mind, and soul, the strength, the power to work for you in these last days. Forgive us, Lord, of all our sins, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.